Hey, welcome to my channel. Glad you're here. Today's video is going to be about how to use the staking tool set to tighten the roller table up on the balance shaft. So let's get started. Before we get into taking this pocket watch apart, I'd like to talk a little bit about it. It's a special pocket watch. This pocket watch is called a Father Time. That was the name Elgin, who was the manufacturer of it, gave this type of pocket watch. They had different names for their pocket watches, but this is a size 18 pocket watch. It's a fairly big size pocket watch. And this was a grade 389. And there was only 4,000 of that grade made, so that made it kind of a special watch. It's kind of a rare watch. And this watch was made in 1911 and it still looks brand new. Now, there's another special thing about this pocket watch. If you notice, the hairspring on this pocket watch is gold. And the gold hairspring was a special order. And you would order it from Elgin, and then you would have the watchmaker put it in. It was an aftermarket thing. And the idea behind the gold was it wouldn't rust. Your hairspring would be rust resistant. So that adds a little bit more value to this pocket watch. And this is a 21 jewel railroad grade Elgin Father Time, made in 1911. Now we have the back cover off. What I'm going to do is I'm going to let down the mainspring on this watch so we can work on it. What I do is I take a little piece of peg wood and move the click out of the way, and I'm holding the winder as it unwinds. With the click moved out of the way, it lets me do a control letdown of the mainspring to let all the tension off of it. So you want to do that so you don't damage your watch. And we'll sit here and watch the mainspring let down as we can see the balance. It's starting to slow down and it'll come to a complete stop. Here we go. Now, since we've got our mainspring let down, the next thing we're going to do is remove the movement from the case. We pull the stem out, and that releases the stem from the movement. And then we take our screwdriver and we're going to remove these two screws. They're called case screws. Now we got our case screws out, and something I should have done in the beginning before I took the screws out probably was to set the time for 12 o'clock, because I'm going to be handling the sometimes you'll take those hands off, but I'm going to leave them on. You set it at 12 o'clock so they're out of the way, so when you take your movement out, you're not pushing on them or taking a chance of damaging them. And when you put them in your movement holder, they're out of the way of anything, so they won't get damaged. Now, if you're going to do any kind of watch repair or watch work, you definitely need a movement holder. So looking at the balance, I can tell right away that there's something going on. The balance wheel should be setting straight like this when it's at rest, when the spring is let off on it. there's no tension on it, but it's not. It's setting at an angle. So that tells me there's something going on, there's something wrong, and most likely is the roller table is shifted on the shaft. The roller table probably was loose. So we're going to take the balance apart, or take the balance out. Now, taking the balance out, you really want to be careful with this. It's a very delicate part. You could damage it, the hairspring, you could damage the pivots on the shaft on the balance. So this is a part where you really want to be careful with. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to loosen the screw that holds the balance onto the balance cock. That's what the part that holds the balance wheel too is called. There's a little screw that I'm taking loose, and there's a stud that rests in that balance cock. I'm just going to flip it over, and I'm going to take my screwdriver and gently push that little stud out. And that'll be able to remove the hairspring. Now that little triangle pieces, that's where that stud goes in. And that little screw there, you want to tighten that back down a little bit, snug it down so you don't lose it. Because you lose that screw and you're going to have a bad day. You'll probably never find another one for it. Well, you probably would, but you know what I'm saying. Now, one handy thing to have is a little parts container where you can put your parts in and keep them from being lost. So here we're looking at the balance, and I'm looking at the roller table, and I can tell it's off center. It should line up with the balance wheel. There's a little black mark that I made on there, and that would be the center, and this is off to the side. So we're going to take the hairspring off and get started with removing the roller table from it. I take my two screwdrivers, pop the hairspring off very carefully. This is the most nerve-wracking part for me, is you don't want to damage the hairspring. Now we have our staking tool set out, and we're going to get started taking that roller table off of that balance. Now the first tool that I'm going to be using is probably one of the most important tools in the staking tool die set. It's the die set punch, and it's only used for centering up the holes in the die plate, and that's the only thing it's really used for. You should never use it for a center punch or anything, or you'll damage the tip. See how we use it, and I tighten down the roller table on it, the die table, I should say. Now we're getting out our stump. That's what that little thing is called, a stump, and it has a little slot in it, and that slot is to protect the roller jewel that's on the balance. That's on the roller table. You don't want to damage the roller jewel, or you'll have to replace it. So we're going to take our balance and set it on there carefully, and line up that little roller jewel with that slit that's in that stump. Zoom in a little bit and you see it better. Now this is the tool, the punch that I'll be using to knock that roller table off that staff. Center it up. You want to be very careful. You don't want to damage your tip of your staff with the punch. this little brass hammer to tap down on it. Just one little tap, there it goes. Comes across, off really easy. Well, that came off easy. Well, one thing I noticed, on the left side of my staking tool, there's a piece of cat hair hanging off of it. Even though those cats aren't allowed in my watch repair room, you know how they are if you have cats. Cat hair gets everywhere. Kind of reminds me of a story I heard once that old-time watchmakers would use their hair from their beard, and if the roller table was loose on the staff, they would take that pull a piece of hair out of their beard and put it in between there and use it to help tighten up their roller table. Not that I would do anything like that. So here we got a roller table on another type of stump. Now this is a punch that I'll be using to tighten that roller table up. If you have a K and D punch set, it's the number on it is the number 12. Mine is a C and E Marshall punch set, and my number is 2M. Those numbers are stamped on the side of the punch, just in case you wanted to know. So what we do is just center that up again, just like we did. Just a light, very light tap. You don't want to hit it very hard because you could crush it. You can see there's four little indentures where it makes a little burr in the center of it. You can barely see it, but those little burrs will form a grip around that shaft when we go to put it back on. It'll tighten it up. So now we're gonna use the same tool that we used to take it off. We'll use the same tool to put the roller table back on with onto the balance. Now I made a little black mark with a Sharpie where I'll know that the way my roller table should face. I use that mark to locate my roller jewel on my roller table. That way it'll be on the same position that it came off. Well, okay, now we're ready to put our roller table back on our balance. We'll take our punch and centered up, and just a light tap. There it goes. Ah, job well done. Now the next thing we're going to do is put our hairspring back onto our balance. We'll get it all lined up. Going to use the same punch that we used to take the roller table off. We use that to push the, and I don't hit on that at all. I just use my finger to on the top of it to press down on it. Doesn't take much to put the hairspring back on. You don't want to bang on that. That'll hairsprings always make me nervous. So now we're gonna put our hairspring back onto our balance cock. We've loosened up that little screw where that triangle was that I showed you earlier. We're gonna line that up and drop the stud into that little triangular hole. I'll take my tweezers and push it down into that little holder for it, the little slot. Sorry about I didn't get a good close-up of that shot, but you can see it. There it is. Push that down in, and that's that little stud. Kind of tricky to get that in there because the hairspring is a spring and it's vibrating all around and it wants to fight you the whole way around. And plus everything's so tiny, I have to wear a magnification to see any of this. Well, we got it all back together, the balance, the hairspring is on, slide it on in there, line it up, drop it in. Notice how I use my tweezers for anything. I try not to touch too much with my fingers. And I do wear those finger protectors so I don't get any oils from my hands on it. Well, it looks good. Yeah. Put that screw in there. Yeah, use those tweezers as like a third hand. You always test your movement and your balance before you finally tighten the screw down, because if you're off a little bit and you tighten it down, it'll crush that the tips of your balance staff. Let's put a little pressure on the mainspring, wind it up, and give it a test run. Oh, it's off and running. See the arms on that balance, the two arms swinging back and forth, and they're staying in the center of the watch, not like before where they were off center. Really like that gold hairspring that stands out, and then the gold lettering that's on the watch. It's really a pretty watch. Well, I hope you learned something, and I hope you liked this video. And if you do like it, hit the like button. And also, hit that subscribe button, so you'll get notifications of any new watchmaking, watch repair videos that I'll be posting.